Welcome to Back to Basics. Today, I will walk you through how to improve the scaling and resiliency of your application using a cell-based architecture. We'll take a closer look at what a cell-based architecture is, its benefits, and application pattern considerations. A few years back, I worked on an API using a typical ELB over an auto-scaling set of instances connected to a replicated database. Over time, the application's popularity grew, increasing total users and traffic. As additional features were added to the application, the system grew in complexity. What started as a small-scale application grew bigger and bigger. As our usage increased, so did the challenges. One of the main challenges we faced was the level of complexity testing such a large system. Issues experienced in production became difficult to reproduce. Some of our components had reached their practical size cap and stopped scaling in spite of utilizing additional compute instances. We looked at communication and coordination overhead between nodes and found hidden contention points, resulting in nonlinear scaling. Managing deployments also became quite complex. Faulty deployments can cause application downtime, and rollbacks can be complicated and messy. These challenges can occur for a number of reasons, such as bad data, infrastructure faults, and other unlikely scenarios. So how can you effectively execute fault containment while scaling to meet customer needs? Or what can you do to reduce the risks during deployments and improve resiliency? These pain points can be mitigated by implementing cell-based architectures. Cell-based architectures are composed of a gateway or thinnest possible router over a collection of cells. The gateway handles routing to the different cells based on each individual request. This provides fault isolation between cells, which are independent replicas of your system. This pattern can be used to prevent outages caused by software bugs, failed deployments, overload, and ultimately reduces impact to your end customers. Here's a migration from a typical architecture into a cell-based architecture. Instead of deploying the app as one system, you deploy multiple copies of the app over a router gateway. You can deploy a cell in multiple ways, as a zonal service or across availability zones. You can shard data based on your business needs, such as customer or geographies. You can add additional cells for bigger customers or shard the data across cells as needed. Cell-based architectures can also span across regions, utilizing other AWS services for routing. This allows you to easily recover against regional outages. Overall, cell-based architectures provide better fault containment through individual cell isolation, higher mean time between failures, meaning faults happen less often, lower mean time to recover by relocating affected cells to another location, easier testability on an individual cell basis, safer deployments to singular cells, increase application scalability by adding cells as needed. When working with cell-based architectures, it is important to understand your application and business needs. Your architecture will change over the lifetime of your application as your requirements change. Cell-based architectures can improve fault isolation and resiliency requirements for your applications. Check out additional resources in the description below. Thanks for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.